the 3-yard line. Pratt awaits the snap, has the snap, and drops back the pass. Big rush on, throws over the middle. It's intercepted by Zaven Collins. Collins left side, 40 to the 50, to the 45, to the 40.
Today, we're going to look at some of the best defensive players that aren't ranked at the top of their position. All of these players could fall to the second round, but in my belief, hold first round potential. Before we get started, I want to take a moment to recognize a new partner of the Prospect Profit, Please Just Cover. Please Just Cover is a new podcast dedicated to your daily sports betting. If you're looking to make a little cash and learn how to always cover your bets, these guys do an amazing job, and more often than not, their bets hit. After starting at quarterback and linebacker for 4 years in high school, Zaven Collins' only Division I offer was from Tulsa. However, Collins ended his collegiate career by claiming the Bronco Naguraki Trophy, which is awarded to the nation's best defensive player. Collins' unbelievable blend of size, power, and football IQ make him as dynamic of a prospect as you can have. His 6'4", 260 build allows them to easily plug the middle of the field and prevent easy runs, while his 4.7 speed allows him to compete with receivers on the edge. If Collins lands in an NFL scheme such as Arizona or New England, where his full versatile skill set can shine, and he's put in multiple alignments, I could see him breaking out early in his career.
What can't Zaven Collins do? We're not sure we know the answer to that question.
In trouble, escapes. Now Nix throws into traffic, and it's intercepted. There's J.C. Horn again.
J.C. Horn is one of the most physical and aggressive cornerbacks in this draft. Cornerback can be one of the most challenging positions in all of football. A college athlete is expected to come in and guard a professional receiver. A lot of the time, this results in them being placed on an island to which the other team can take advantage of. J.C. Horn, however, doesn't shy away from the spotlight. Coming into his senior season, Horn had 17 career pass breakups and 2 forced fumbles in 23 games. According to Pro Football Focus, he has played 1,426 snaps, with opponents targeting his receiver just 100 times for 57 completions and 2 touchdowns. In his senior season, he played 7 games, stealing 2 interceptions, before opting out of the rest of the season to prepare for the draft. For teams such as Dallas, Denver, or even the Raiders, Horn could be an excellent pick to help improve their secondary. My biggest concern with Horn is that the physical nature of his game could result in him drawing more pass interference calls. However, I believe his athletic skill set will let him lock up players to the next level. Patrick Jones II, the consensus All-American out of Pitt, has the technical skill set as well as the build to contribute to a D-line in the pros. In 2020, he started 11 contests at defensive end, recording 44 tackles, 13 for loss, 9 sacks, and a fumble recovery. He led the ACC and was ranked 5th in the nation in sacks. Now, the biggest concerns with Jones come from his lack of experience with different defensive schemes. He's a 4-3 defensive end who has little experience in a stand-up role or dropping back in coverage. As a pass rusher, he gets out of his stance extremely fast and understands how to evade blocking exceedingly well. Against the run, he's quick to fill up the A-gap, and his lateral quickness allows him to reach the outside if needed. I think Jones will find most success in an even front defense. I think the Chicago Bears could be a good landing spot for him, as they've explored mainly with the 4-2-5 nickel defensive scheme recently, which would help accentuate Jones' strengths and could be a good spot for Jones with the 20th overall pick. Ultimately, all of these defensive players could be late first rounders, if not second round steals, and we all know defense wins championships. As always, thanks for watching, remember to subscribe, and go check out the Please Just Cover podcast to make yourself a little cash.